Hey, mamas, it's your CajunStork here. Are you wondering what is a water birth? Well, today I'm going to talk to you about water birth and why it might be something you want to consider. But before I begin, my name is Midwife Kira, and I believe in truly natural birth because I know it makes for better birth experiences. Consider subscribing to my channel and don't forget to grab your midwife recommended birth packing supply list in my description below. So let's talk about what is water birth. Well, first of all, I want to talk about the difference between water birth and water immersion. Water birth is when we talk about the actual delivery of the baby in the water. And water immersion is when we labor in the water, but we may not necessarily deliver in the water. Now, the biggest difference obviously is that one of them we deliver the baby and the other one we labor in the water, but there's also some benefits to both. Water immersion in labor has been known as like the aquadural in the sense that it takes the place of the epidural in regards to pain relief. There are so many studies and benefits of laboring in the water. And if you're the kind of person that when you get a stomach virus, you want to like go climb into the bathtub, or when you don't feel good, that's kind of like your happy place. You will definitely love laboring in the water during your upcoming labor. Now, water birth is a little different. Personally, I didn't really like being in the water when I was in labor because I'm one of those moms that likes to feel grounded. I want to feel myself like touch the earth. But there are several benefits of delivering in the water that you're gonna love. One of the biggest study benefits is that when you deliver in the water, you are less likely to have a vaginal tear and you're less likely to have an episiotomy, which makes sense because your care providers can't be cutting episiotomies when you're submersed in the water, which is great. Some other benefits are the more relaxing, peaceful environment can actually help you have a more comfortable delivery. One of my favorite benefits of delivering in the water is that you can be in multiple pushing positions during the birth. So because you're floating in the water, you can lay on your back without actually like being flat on your back. You can turn on your left side. You can deliver in hands and knees. And I'm coming to you from the birth tub here at the Natural Birth House, where we have these awesome little handles right here on the birth tub. And these are really great because I can actually hang on to these handles and float when we're in labor. Which is really comfortable and really awesome. Another thing too about water birth is that mamas feel more control in their labor and their birth experience because they're not, I guess the best way to put it is as a medical professional, we have less opportunities to like put our hands on the mamas while they're in labor. They're kind of in their own little space right here. We kind of have to be more hands off, which is really great. The one thing I want you guys to know about water birth though is yes, water birth is safe, but it is safest when it is attended by a skilled provider. And sadly, I don't mean your OBGYN in this circumstance. Midwives are skilled birth attendants who are trained in water birth throughout their training. And so water birth isn't like other birth. You know, we have to know the specific water temperature. We have to know how to prevent cross-contamination. We have to know how to quickly and most easily and safely deliver the baby to prevent the baby from being underwater too long. And so there's a lot of things that are really important that a skilled provider needs to be in attendance for your water birth. And so this is why I really don't recommend water birth in a basic hospital setting. Locally in our hospitals, the few doctors who have agreed to allow moms to deliver in the water, what they say is that you can deliver in the water, but you have to get out immediately after the birth to deliver your placenta in the bed. And so the moment that you're lifting your baby up onto your chest and you're supposed to be like soaking in that moment and loving on your baby and that immediate skin to skin that we all know is so important, you're very abruptly being removed from the tub and moved to the bed to deliver your placenta. And this can really impact your experience and your hormones after the birth. If you want a water birth, my best recommendation is to go outside of the hospital and seek a midwife. As a midwife, one of the things that I love about water birth is how precious the babies are when they're born in the water. So when babies are born in the water, it's like freedom! They come out, they kick their little feet, they swim around the pool before we lift them up. Now this is seconds, y'all. We're not like leaving them under the water. But like as soon as they're free, their little feet kick and it's just so precious to see them do that. We lift them up, we put them straight on mom's chest. They get the warmth of the water to keep their skin warm. It's an easier transition from the uterine environment, which is also a water environment, into the birth tub and onto mama's chest. And I just think that babies love water births as much as midwives do. So are you considering having a water birth, or maybe you had an amazing water birth experience and you want to share it with us? Please let us know in the comments below. Otherwise, I made these two videos right here for you. This is my midwife recommended birth tub. It's the birth tub I use at the birth house. If you want to learn a little bit more about a tub that you might love during labor, or this video right here where we talk about the truths of water birth and answer the most common questions about, is water birth safe? I'll see you over there. Thanks for watching this Midwife Monday. Bye-bye.